Greetings from Academia IAPSM eConnect team. This channel represents the eConnect initiative under Academia IAPSM. This initiative aims at engaging experts, students, and citizens around pressing the public health issues. We are initiating a series of videos on the recent updates in public health at every 2-month interval. This is the first video in this series. In this capsule, our team, the frontliners, had made an attempt to summarize all the relevant events, new evidences, and news of public health interest during the previous 2 months, that is the June and July 2021. I am Dr. Dipanshi Saxena, and I will tell you about the important and the prevalent topics. Let us see what happened recently about the tuberculosis control in India. To bridge the gap between the missing cases and to make the India TB free, by the year 2030, the Government of India has developed the guidelines for programmatic management of drug-resistant tuberculosis and the NTB strategy brochure. And the NTEP provides simplified regimen for drug-resistant tuberculosis, including shorter oral bidaquiline-containing MDR-resistant and rifampicin-resistant tuberculosis regimen and longer oral, multi-drug, and extensively drug-resistant tuberculosis regimen. Coming to the updates on leprosy. In the purview of COVID-19 pandemic, the report on disproportionate impact on leprosy, focusing on the root causes, consequences, and the way to recovery was published. The Leprosy Diagnostic Working Group has developed a test which is claimed to be the first diagnostic test to confirm the diagnosis of leprosy in individuals with clinical signs and symptoms. The next topic is influenza. In context of acute lower respiratory infections in infant and young children, WHO has scheduled a meeting for the composition of influenza virus vaccines and its use in the southern hemisphere. Moving to a worrisome news regarding the immunization. The COVID-19 pandemic and associated disruptions have strained health systems, with 23 million children missing out of the vaccination in 2020. This is the highest number since 2009. Then, the updates on hepatitis. With a person dying every 30 seconds from a hepatitis-related illness, even in the current COVID-19 crisis, we can't wait to act on the viral hepatitis. Therefore, the WHO is calling on all the countries to work together for its elimination. Moving to the next slide. In context of increased unwarranted antibiotic uses, the Global Antimicrobial Resistance and Use Surveillance System report was launched with a new key component on the antimicrobial consumption surveillance. Moving ahead to the next slide. The WHO has started drafting the Global Alcohol Action Plan to strengthen the implementation of the global strategy to reduce the harmful use of alcohol. Now, there is something on bird flu. Coming to the next slide, the first suspected human case of a new variant of bird flu, H5NX, was reported from Gurugram, Haryana. The information was communicated to the IDSP State Surveillance Unit to initiate an epidemiological investigation after a 11-year-old child died at AIIMS, New Delhi. Fortunately, the NIV Pune didn't find it to be a suspected case of bird flu. Now, I would like to call Dr. Pooja Pathak to take over.
Thank you, Dr. Dipanshi. On 21st June 2021, the 7th International Day of Yoga, our Honorable Prime Minister launched M-Yoga app. This app has been developed in collaboration with WHO and Ministry of Ayush with an aim of be healthy and be mobile and to combat various non-communicable diseases. This app focuses on general wellness, mental health, adolescent and pre-diabetic health. The next is the Cabinet approved a new scheme, India COVID-19 Emergency Response and Health System Preparedness Package Phase 2. The scheme aims to accelerate health system preparedness and strengthen immediate responsiveness for early prevention, detection, and management of various diseases. The next one is drowning. Drowning is among 10 leading causes of death among youth all over the world, with the Southeast Asia region having second highest incidence. On 25th July 2021, the first World Drowning Prevention Day was observed. WHO released the guidelines on the prevention of drowning, addressing the provision of daycare of children and basic swimming skills and water safety training. The next is the Government of India has launched the National Policy for Rare Diseases 2021 in public domain. The main aim of the policy is to lower the incidence and prevalence of rare diseases. It also provides financial support to the population under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana and Rashtriya Arogya Nidhi. Now, some updates on maternal and child health. Global Polio Eradication Initiative has launched a new strategy with two primary goals. Goal one is to permanently interrupt all polio virus transmission in endemic countries, and goal two is to stop vaccine-derived polio virus transmission and prevent its outbreak in non-endemic countries. Next, a new research published by WHO says that cesarean section is increasing continuously all over the world, and estimated that it will be 29% of all the births by 2030. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Subhashi Das to continue further.
Thank you, Dr. Pooja. I shall continue with updates on maternal and child health. Updated recommendations by WHO now focuses on early ultrasound scan, considering benefits, harms, values and preferences, feasibility, equity, ethics and resource requirements. Moving ahead to updates on COVID-19 and pregnancy. On 2nd July 2021, Government of India accepted the recommendation of Immunization Advisory Group to vaccinate pregnant women against COVID-19. Next topic is COVID-19 and children. Government of India has released guidelines on early part of June for children affected due to COVID-19. It includes identification of children due to COVID-19, vigilance and protection, emergency care, rehabilitation, and support through child care institutions. Coming to the next update on PM CARE scheme for children. To financially support children who have lost their parents or guardians to COVID-19 pandemic after 11th March 2020, this scheme is accessible through an online portal. Some new recommendations have been given by WHO regarding screening, treatment, and elimination of cervical cancer by the year 2030. WHO also suggests HPV DNA detection in two approaches, that are a screen and treat approach or screen, trial and treat approach, starting at the age of 30 years with regular screening every 5 to 10 years. Moving ahead to the next topic, One Nation, One Card scheme, which was launched by Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 30th June. Previously, it included One Nation, One FASTag to ensure seamless mobility in the country. Likewise, now it includes One Nation, One Mobility Card for different modes of transport across different states, and One Nation, One Ration Card scheme, which enables the migrant beneficiaries to get their entitled quota of food grains from any electronic point of sale, enabled fair price shops of their choice anywhere in the country. Now, updates on non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, abbreviated as NAFLD. NAFLD become a part of non-communicable disease control program, where erstwhile Union Minister Dr. Harshvardhan launched operational guidelines for integration of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease with NPCDCS. The last update in this video is on Zika virus. The first case of Zika virus was reported on July 8, 2021. Till end of July, we have reported 51 confirmed cases of Zika virus infection in India. The Government of India has implemented a strategic framework for prevention of Zika virus transmission. We end our presentation here. Our team, the frontliners, consist of Dr. Sobhit Garg, myself, Dr. Subhashri Das, Dr. Abhijit, Dr. Dipanshi, Dr. Pooja, and Dr. Mohit. We want to take a moment here to thank Academia IAPSM eConnect team, Dr. Malate sir, Dr. Parag sir, Dr. Sanjeev sir, Dr. A.M. Kadri sir, for giving us this opportunity and bringing all of us to this platform. We also want to extend our gratitude towards senior IAPSM office bearer team for their full support.
If you have come this far in the video, that means you have got the knowledge and information about various updated public health topics. Academia IAPSM eConnect will be coming soon with the next update of 2 months, that is August and September 2021. Please subscribe to our channel, Academia IAPSM eConnect, and click on the bell icon on the right side of the video. Till then, stay connected and stay safe.